Hi friends, welcome back. Sorry, in last video I couldn't show you how to pack the clay. So I have packed my clay in a zip wrap. Zip wrap cover you generally use to wrap your vegetables, leftover vegetables, fruits. Or you can use Ziploc bags also. And to preserve it, you can keep the Ziploc bag inside a Tupperware or any airtight box and then store it in the refrigerator. So actually I'm going to make a pen stand, a different type of pen stand, for which I need plastic container like this. This is actually a asafoetida container. So I just need this. I'm going to make a face around this and then I'm going to make hands on which the face is resting. So let's start with the face. To smoothen the clay, you can use water. And to do any carving, I'm using just a simple pencil. So let's get started. Initially, to start with, I'm applying some Fevicol. Let me just cover it with one layer. I'll try to smoothen it. This clay takes around 24 hours to get dry. So like this, I'll cover the whole jar. It's not compulsory to take the same size jar. I have taken whatever is available with me. You can take any waste jar from your kitchen. So when I want to merge two different clay, I'll apply some water and smoothen it. As I have not switched off my fan, so I can keep my clay open. It will not dry that much. But if you are doing the clay work by switching on the fan, then please cover your clay with the plastic. Otherwise, the upper layer of the clay will get dry. I have taken a plastic sheet here I'll fully smoothen it. I want an even layer. Now I want my lower part of the jar to be little bit bulgy. So I'll take some clay. I'll roll it like this. I'm trying to merge it. I'm trying to merge both the layers. I'm not using any tool here. You can directly do everything with your hands. See, you can smoothen it with your palm. The lower part is looking a little bit bulgy. Have to decide which side of the jar I'm going to keep it as the front portion so that I can make rest of the features. going to keep this as my front portion. Now we are going to finish this. There are many different versions of paper mache clay. Some people make it using chalk powder, some people make it using ceramic powder. But they are for different purpose also. Now I am going to finish this portion. Now, before going to the next step, I'm going to let this dry very nicely. So, I'm going to keep it upside down and let it dry. Don't worry about this portion, this will be covered. We are going to make palms for this. In next video, I'll show you how we are going to convert this into a beautiful face. So I'll keep it like this. Making a ball, I'm going to press it like this and I'm going to place here. If your jar is little bit long in size, still you can do the same step. don't have to keep on adding water. Just dip your fingers inside the water and you can smoothen it like this. It is just a little bit similar to terracotta clay. Initially, you will find this clay to be very heavy while doing, but once the water is evaporated, this clay becomes very lightweight. So, can you see I'm giving it a very nice shape? You can smoothen it with water how much ever you want. Then rest of the smoothing we can do with the sandpaper. Thank you friends, thanks for watching. Let's continue in the next video.